Welcome to Enhancing the Human Experience. This is episode 87, and it's all about the magic of helping yourself. And as you can hear, I still have a little bit of that head cold that I had going on last episode. I'm definitely on the downhill slide, but it's going to affect the way I sound on this episode of the podcast. And I'm going to go back and edit out all of the coughs and like clearing my throat, so you don't have to listen to that. But you will have to listen to my nasally kind of voice this episode. But the thing I want to share with you in this episode, and the magic of this notion of helping yourself, is based on the idea that we as human beings have a high propensity to help other people much more so than we will help ourselves. And I there's lots of reasons for that. I have theories of why that happens. The biggest theory is I think it's like a we've been conditioned that way in our society and in our culture. And this goes back to like prehistoric times, right? There's great value in helping other people reach their goals and get what they need, because it's kind of this reciprocal altruism. I forget the name of the book, but many years ago, I read this book. And well, actually, I do remember the name. It was called The Moral Animal. And it's this notion that, you know, human beings and other animals too, animals are like this, right? We help one another in order to help ourselves. But sometimes we help other people much more than we help ourselves, you know, whether it's helping them implement an idea or a strategy in a business, or helping out a friend in their life. How many times has a friend come to you with a problem and you've helped them solve that problem? And you've helped them get past that, and you get really invested in their success. Well, what I want to offer you in this episode of the podcast is to be invested in your own success, and to actually see yourself as being your best friend or your friend that's in need, because that's what we really are. We are our own friend that's in need, and we are constantly being called to help ourselves on a daily basis in business, in life, in our health and wellness, in relationships, to help solve our own problems. Because we have to remember that all of us have a best friend inside of us, and that is our higher self, that is our infinite self, our inner being, whatever you want to call it, right? The soul, the wisdom that resides inside of you, that is your ultimate best friend. And so that's really the message that I want to share with you on this episode of the podcast. I'm going to talk about some ideas. I'm going to talk about some resources, some really awesome resources that you can go pick up that are kind of talking around this. But at the end of the day, it's all about helping yourself as you would help your best friend. Because inside of you, the inner wisdom that you have has the answers to solve your problems. And again, it doesn't matter what area of life you have a problem in, you have the ability to help yourself and solve that problem. This is also the notion that the idea that Emerson was talking about when he's talking about self-reliance, right? Those little ideas that come up within us and guide us to what we should do in order to help ourselves. But because of, this is kind of going back to the reason this doesn't happen, because of self-doubt, low self-worth, low self-confidence, all of these things, we squash that idea down and we don't implement that idea. We don't help ourselves, right? We don't be self-reliant, which is what we have to be. And again, not so much focusing on why the cause of that is in this episode. Sometimes I think we can get lost in talking about the whys, because ultimately it doesn't really matter why it happens, but being conscious and aware of the fact that we are much more apt to help another person, especially a good friend, than we are to help ourselves in business or in life, is all we really need to know. And when we wake up to that fact, we're like, oh, right, I need to help myself, because if we don't help ourselves, we can't help other people, right? We can't be benefit to other people. And so often we just dismiss our own like life and prosperity and abundance and put all of our attention on helping other people. And that's fine, but it's not the best route. Even on an airplane, what is the common thing that they say? They say, put your oxygen mask on first, and then put your oxygen mask on your child or those around you that need your help. But it's that putting your oxygen mask on first that we have to focus on. And this is something that I think just because of the way we're conditioned, back to that moral animal thing, we tend to overlook this quite often. So one of the kind of the pieces, the documents that fed into this episode was something written by Seth Godin, and it is absolutely fantastic. I'm going to share it here on the podcast, but I'm also going to share the information about where you can go and how you can pick it up on my social media, which is at G Mark Phillips, or if you're on Facebook, it's at G Mark Phillips Fan, F-A-N. And it's a document called Pick Yourself. And you can find this document online. Just Google Pick Yourself PDF, and somehow it will come up. And it's a one-page document written by Seth Godin. And the thing of it is, it's one of his more obscure pieces of literature, for lack of a better word. It's one of his more obscure pieces, but I find it to be infinitely valuable. I'm actually working on a vlog post right now where I'm going to share 10 books that will help you succeed in business and in life. And just a little bit of a teaser, a little bit of like spoiler alert, this document is one of the documents I'm going to share at the very end of that episode, because all those 10 books won't mean anything if you don't pick yourself first. Right? You can have all the business knowledge, all the health, wealth, and success knowledge in the world, but unless you pick yourself and help yourself and say, look, I'm going to help myself succeed, then it won't matter. Because if you don't have that high self-worth and high self-value and self-deservedness, it won't matter. You'll always be subject to this notion of putting something else before yourself, putting someone else before you. And that's why it's so important, this document, Pick Yourself, and also this episode of the podcast, which is like the broader theme, helping yourself, you know. So this document is super awesome. It's one page, and it's basically the heart of it is this. We are conditioned to wait for someone to pick us. We wait for a school to pick us, and I don't care if you're trying to get into an elite kindergarten school, or elite preschool, or an elite public education school or a charter school. We're waiting for someone to pick us. That's total baloney. We cannot wait for people to pick us, because then you have totally given your power over to another person. Now I realize that that's part of life and that is kind of the game that we're playing, but at least be conscious of what you're doing. And we're further conditioned to wait for someone else to pick us when we go to college. You submit your letter of application, you wait for the college to pick you, right? We're further conditioned after you get out of college and you go to get a job. You submit your application, your resume, and you fill out an application, and you wait for your job or employer to pick you. You know what? Nothing wrong with that. We have to have that, and I'm not poo-pooing that at all. I'm just saying, be conscious of the fact that you have been conditioned to want other people to pick you and to wait for other people to pick you. There is a point at some point in your life where that scale will tip and it'll become detrimental. And really that point is all along the whole process. We should always be sowing seeds and picking ourselves all the way along, either having side businesses or side investing in ourselves, whether it's in education or personal development, those kind of things. That's picking yourself, that's developing your self-worth, developing your self-confidence. All these things are picking yourself. It doesn't necessarily have to be a business endeavor, although that's the best way to pick yourself, because when you hire yourself, and that's one of the things that I want to talk about in this episode, that's the ultimate picking of yourself. And again, it doesn't mean that you have to forego working for someone else. It can be very beneficial and it can be very enjoyable to be part of a team and be on someone else's team, right? In our day and age, if we get this narrow-mindedness and say, this is the only thing I'm going to do, it can limit us, not only in terms of our own development, but in our own happiness and joy. So I definitely don't want to say, pick yourself and tune out the whole world. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is pick yourself in addition to picking someone or allowing other person to pick you or allowing a company to pick you or an other extracurricular activity. But we've been so conditioned and the scale has tipped so far to the side of non-self-reliance, non-self-love, non-self-worth, self-confidence, that it's actually becoming detrimental for us. And what happens then is that we only learn how to have other people pick us, or we only learn how to help other people, and we never learn how to help ourselves. We never learn how to hire ourselves. And that's a real problem for many, many reasons. And that's the heart of this episode, is to help yourself first and be conscious of when you're helping someone else, right? Helping yourself and help someone else. Really, the whole goal here is to tip the scales back into a balance of helping yourself and helping other people. Because at the end of the day, and this is something that I think all of us know on a deep intuitive level, but we don't want to admit to ourselves, we think that when we help another person, that they will be there for us when we need help. And you know what? That's true to a degree, but let's look at the reality here. They have their own hopes and dreams, they have their own goals and desires, and no one is going to ever put someone else's needs above their own survival and realization of their dreams. And you know what? That's totally awesome. That's totally awesome. We have to just be conscious that if we want to help ourselves reach our goals and dreams, we've got to be aware of that. And just don't put all of our eggs in someone else's basket or at someone else's mercy, right? That's the whole thing that this episode is all about. Because the whole reason that Seth Godin wrote this one-page article is because as change occurs, change is the only constant. We know this in the universe and in our world and in business. As the structures in business were breaking down, corporations were letting people go. Because look, what are they doing? They're helping themselves. Nothing wrong with that. But all the people that worked there thought, this is going to be stable forever. I'm going to go out and buy homes and cars and everything, and I'm going to be able to work here forever. It's going to be just fine and dandy. And you know what? That didn't happen. When that corporation started to hemorrhage money and started to, when people stopped buying stuff, what do they have to do? They have to shed off anything and everything in order to keep the corporation alive. And this is the same way that human beings are as well. Again, nothing wrong with it. But we have to realize and be conscious, if we haven't sowed seeds and if we haven't helped ourselves in developing ourselves or developing side opportunities, we'll be in a real world of hurt at that point in time. And Seth Godin wrote this because he said, hey, the whole dynamic is changing. The world's changing. No one's going to pick you. And he specifically talks about Dick Clark is not going to pick you to be the next band and go world famous. Oprah's not going to pick your book to be on her Oprah book tour or her, like, whatever she's promoting, right? She's not going to catapult you to success because she's struggling in order to reorient herself in the new economy and this new dynamic that's going on as well. No one has it figured out. No one has it figured out. It's always changing and it's always in flux. Now, people can see how the game is being played and conditions are changing, right? As long as you know that it's always changing, you kind of do have it figured out. But even the pro players, look how many pro players, whether they're in media, whether they're in business, whether they're in whatever, have been eaten up and gobbled up by the changes that have occurred in our economy in just the last 5 to 10 years, right? As these cycles are coming around, and of course, we don't even want to get into the fact of why these cycles are occurring, but this is just the natural ebb and flow and rhythm of nations and currencies and societies. It just happens, right? This is the cycle of chaos and destruction that is always happening in our universe. That's a whole other podcast right there, though. But even the big players were taken down. Even the major, whether it's motion picture studios, whether it's entertainment companies or music companies, even they couldn't figure it out. And some of those people and those companies lost in the game. So waiting for someone to pick you, and I might add, waiting for someone who doesn't know what's going to happen in the future any more than you do to pick you is a loser's game, for lack of a better word. Fine to play that game. Just know that that's what's happening. If a seasoned business that has been around for whatever, 40, 50 years, cannot navigate those rough waters and those turbulent seas, then who can, right? If no one knows the game, we have to pick ourselves. We have to be self-reliant. And the thing that I also want to offer you is, remember that your best friend inside of you, it knows what you should do. Your higher self, your inner being knows what you should do in order to navigate those seas. It knows exactly where you should go, what you should do, how you should play this move and this hand that you've been given in order to have the ultimate success that you want. And that's the thing that, for the most part, we haven't been conditioned to do in our society and our culture. We're always taught to look to authority. We're always taught to have someone pick ourselves, you know, pick us in school and education and a job. And it's so, so detrimental because at the end of the day, when the thing crashes and when things crumble down, you're left with only yourself. That person who picked you or was the authority figure, they've moved on, right? This is the same thing that happens in corporations who have CEOs that get golden parachutes after they crash a company, regardless of how they did it, regardless of whether their ego got involved, which is mostly the case, right? Quite frankly, whether they've stacked the board in their favor to help them do certain things, they're the ones that always come off scot-free. It's always the employees and the people that have played the game thinking they, the authority figure, whether it's a CEO, a boss, a corporation, a government official, is going to save them and help them. Don't play that game. Don't play that game. I think you probably realize this by now, but if not, please realize it again. Pick up Seth Godin's one-page PDF, pick yourself, write it down on a piece of paper to help yourself like your best friend. Another resource I want to share with you is Kamal Ravikant's book, Help Yourself Like Your Life Depended on It. And depending on whether I actually go through with this, I'm actually going to title the episode of this podcast either Help Yourself or Help Yourself Like Your Life Depended on It. And I'm leaning towards the latter there because that's really what has to happen. You have to help yourself. We all have to help ourselves like our life depended on it, because ultimately it does. Who else is going to help us? Who else cares more than you? Who else cares more about you than you? Who else loves you more than you, right? And you have to be the authority figure. We all have to be the authority figure in our own lives and help ourselves like we would help that best friend or like we would help that business. Maybe you have a great business idea. Maybe you have a marketing mind and you have all these ideas about how to help your friend's business succeed or this person's business succeed. Why not help your own business succeed? Why not pick your own self and be constantly thinking of that notion of hiring yourself, helping yourself, loving yourself, and picking yourself? So that's what I want to share on this episode of the podcast. And I think just knowing that and being consciously aware of it is the ultimate thing we need to do, because we just need to realize we've been conditioned all of our lives to let other people help us and let other people navigate our way to wherever we want to be, whether it's in school or in business and life, all those areas. So that's the gist of the podcast that I want to share with you. But I do have a couple of announcements before we wrap up. And the first of which is, along with this notion of helping yourself, I want to share with you a product that is very close to becoming online. Now, this is something that I developed earlier this year and had hosted at one of the online, let's call them course websites. So we won't mention any names, but you know what? Here it is, this classic case of scenario coming full circle. There, it's back to this notion of, again, if you want to have something done right, you've got to do it yourself. So this online course website was, they market themselves as, okay, you put your course up here, we market it for you, we do all this stuff, and we've got all this traffic. Well, you know what? The course didn't sell very well on that website. And so I said to myself recently, within the last month or so, Mark, just take it back off there, market it yourself, put it on your own platform. I've got a website coming out that I'll share with you here in a moment, and market and sell it myself. And the course is called The 7 Pillars of Personal Development, Supporting an Extraordinary Life. And the idea is this, all about what we've been talking about today. There is an unseen support system that supports your goals and dreams, or the realization of your goals and dreams. And that is what I call the 7 pillars of personal development. It's the behind the scenes support system that isn't pretty. It's not fun. It doesn't have anything to do with your ultimate realization of your goals and dreams. But on the other hand, it has everything to do with your realization of your goals and dreams. It's all about creating the self-love, the self-confidence, the self-worth. There's 7 pillars. Self-trust. It's all about creating those 7 pillars that are the behind-the-scenes networks. They're not fancy. They're not flashy. It's not fun. It's not a vision board. But you know what? It is the most important thing. What supports a house? The foundation supports a house. If you have the most extravagant house, we all know this analogy, right? This is nothing new. If you have the most extravagant house built with the finest finishes, the pools and spas and indoor slides and 10-car garages, and it is built without a foundation, do you want to live in that house? You won't want to live in that house. It'll crumble very quickly. Everything needs a firm foundation. But again, back to the way we live our lives, we are focused so much on the outer thing, right? The quick fix, the fast success, the fake it till you make it mentality. All those things don't ultimately have any longevity, right? Because there's no foundation. No one wants to build the foundation. Everyone wants to build the fancy house. I don't think anyone ever clips out magazine articles or goes on Pinterest and says, I want the coolest foundation, I want the most sturdy, structurally sound foundation. No, you pick out pictures of your bathroom, your walk-in closet, your garage, your workroom, your office. That's the fun part. But what I want to encourage you to think about is think about that foundation. If you don't have the self-worth, well, what do we know? Self-worth relates and is a mirror of your net worth in life. All of our net worth in life can be traced back to our self-worth. But how often do we develop that self-worth? Or do we spend time contemplating and doing things that develop ourselves at that level of thought and our level of consciousness? Again, all these things are behind the scenes. So I'm really excited to put this course back on my website and market it in that way. And it's going to also be sold on my product and apparel website, focusandflowusa.com, focusandflowusa.com, because I'm also selling digital products on that Shopify-hosted product and apparel line. So really excited to put it in a number of places, but very excited to introduce this to you. Like I said, it's a little bit premature. We're still probably a couple weeks out. I just uploaded all the videos to the new platform the other day, and I'm going to be rolling this out, but I'll announce it here on my podcast and also on my social media channels. But again, it's called The 7 Pillars of Personal Development, Supporting an Extraordinary Life. Super, super valuable. And one of the things that I find most important to having extraordinary experiences. The other thing I want to say is, again, if you haven't picked up Just Be It, The Secret to Having What You Want in Life, you can go to justbeitbook.com and check out all the resources, all the things that are available in that. That's my product, all built around helping you develop the state of being that will help you support and create the life that you want, that will bring those experiences about, right? We live in a universe that is ruled by cause and effect. When you become the cause of the experiences you want to have, you will have those experiences. It doesn't matter whether you want to say create those experiences or attract those experiences. I kind of look at them in the same way in a matter of words. But the new module that I just recently developed, nearly 2 years after I developed the first modules, is called How to Make a Being Board 2.0. And this thing closes the gap on your goals and dreams, where you're at now and where you want to be, the things you want to be, do, and have in life. And I'm really excited about this because the Being Board 2.0 focuses on who you need to be in order to attract or create the experiences you want to have in life. If you've already picked up the product, you already know that the Being Board focused on what you need to be. And I'm talking about the qualities, characteristics, and attributes, which is vital as well. These are more of the things that are common to all of us, because the what we need to be is really universal. Things like tenacious, driven, focused, committed, those kind of things, regardless of what dreams and goals you have in life, everybody needs those. Everybody needs to be focused. Everybody needs to be committed to their goal and dream. They need to be driven. They need to be tenacious. They need to be audacious when you choose in your goal and dream. Those kind of things are universal, still super valid, but really they're kind of half of the equation, 50% of the equation. The other thing is something totally unique to you. Something that only you know. And that's why there's no example for the Being Board 2.0. If you've checked out my social media, you'll see that it's a blank page with a big question mark. That's the Being Board 2.0. I can't make an example because I don't know your specific goals and dreams. I don't know the person that you need to become in order to realize your goals and dreams. Just like there's no way of you to know the person that I need to become in order to realize my goals and dreams. Remember, being is the cause, having it is the experience. And so this is the most exciting. I was thrilled about the Being Board 1.0, even though I didn't call it that at the time, but I was thrilled about that at the time because it's a visual representation of the qualities, characteristics, and attributes that you need to embody. You can look at it, you can embody those ideas. Remember, all that we are is the result of what we have thought. This is what the Buddha taught us. This is what all metaphysicians think us. When you hold an idea in your mind of audacious, tenacious, committed, and driven, you're going to be that way. You are going to be that way. What we focus on expands, and what we think about, we bring about. If you never entertain a thought of failure or defeat or giving up, you're never going to do that. It's not going to be part of your consciousness. It won't be part of your program that you're running, and you won't have those experiences. This is the heart of what a being board and what the magic of being or the quality of being really is and how it can translate into your own life. But really, really excited for this new module, Being Board 2.0. It's up and ready. It's in the downloads. That is available through the link in either the Kindle version or the PDF version of Just Be It, The Secret to Having What You Want in Life. You can pick it up on Amazon, or you can go to justbeitbook.com. You can download the PDF version if you want, if you don't want to have it on Kindle. So super excited about that. All right, let's wrap up the podcast at that point in time. I was thrilled you listened to me today. I hope this helps you on your journey. I find great meaning and great value in this notion of helping yourself and being self-reliant. This is the same thing, like I said, Emerson talked about. Don't poo-poo the ideas that come to you. Nurture that relationship with your inner being, your inner guidance system. That's your best friend. That's all of our best friend. It's so, so important. So important. Treat yourself like your best friend. Take yourself out to dinner. Go get a massage. Take a walk by the park. I mean, do something super nice for yourself. Be your own business partner, right? Make your inner being, your higher self, your co-CEO, or your trainer, your personal trainer, or your best friend, whatever else. Because there's another thing that's going on here, and this is like one of the unseen benefits. Your relationship with yourself is going to be mirrored in your relationship with other people and the world in general. This is one of the things that all metaphysicians talk about. Most right in my mind right now is something that Neville Goddard says, and he's said that. He said, hey, your relationship with yourself is going to be mirrored in your experience. That's going to happen. And so that's an awesome byproduct of developing your relationship with yourself and listening to yourself and letting yourself, your higher self, your inner being, your all-knowing self, your soul, guide you. Sting talked about it in his famous song, Let Your Soul Guide You. I think about that all the time as well. Don't wait for other people to pick you. Don't wait for other people to help you. Help yourself. You have everything you have, everything you need, you have inside of you. We all have everything we need inside of us. We just need to pick ourselves. We just need to help ourselves and love ourselves and trust ourselves, all those things. It's a self game here, right? This is the whole game of life. It's all an inner game. We nurture that self and help ourselves. It becomes the outer world tunes into what's going on inside of us. So it's really, really vital. Okay, that's the podcast. I really appreciate you listening. Before we wrap up, you can always catch these on any of your favorite podcast apps. You can catch them on my website, gmarkphillips.com, or on YouTube a week or two, maybe three after they come out, youtube.com/gmarkphillips. That's it. That's the podcast. Thanks for listening to my nasally kind of congested voice here. I really do appreciate it. And hopefully next episode will be all back to good again and sounding more normal and relatable. So anyway, hey, thanks so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate it. Have an awesome week. And until next time, all the best, health, wealth, and success. Bye-bye.